Accessing your home network from the internet can be a tricky thing. Maybe you have a home automation software and want to trigger an action, or verify a sensor at home, or you want to check the IP cameras at home while you are away. Finding your home from the internet can be done with dynamic DNS services such as DynDNS, DDNS, NoIP, and so on. But how do you get into your home network? For sure, you have a firewall that is meant to prevent exactly that. Someone from the internet accessing your systems at home. Now, you might just open a hole in your firewall and forward traffic, let's say to that webcam in your living room, which is of course protected with a password. But username and password are actually quite weak protections. They can be broken with lexical analysis and brute force attacks, meaning someone finds the hole and tests thousands of commonly used passwords in seconds. Furthermore, devices tend to have bugs. When have you last updated the firmware of your 5-year-old webcam? Never? Well, then chances are high that the system does have a lot of security issues and that an exploit can be used to gain access to it. In order to access your home environment from the internet, you may use a VPN. That is, you install a VPN software on a PC or in a Docker container or on a Raspberry Pi, or, of course, and this is the preferred solution, directly on your router at home. You will still have to open a hole on your firewall, but the VPN is designed to resist against wrong logins and also it uses a stronger authentication mechanism. Rather than using a simple username and password, a good VPN uses modern encryption technologies such as a private and public key or a certificate and private key that have been signed by a certification authority. This way, connections can be refused before they open any buggy web pages in your intranet that ask for username and password and could easily be hacked. For the home user, there are mainly two VPN solutions that are of interest. One is called OpenVPN and the other one is the new kid on the block and is called Wireguard. Today's episode will be about setting up a Wireguard VPN on an OpenWrt router and using an iPhone to connect to it from the internet. The first step before we want to do anything on OpenWrt is always to check the OpenWrt website, because the documentation there is very well maintained. Quickly googling for WireGuard, OpenWrt leads us to the right webpage with very detailed instructions on how to set things up. Now I know that many people do not like the command line and would rather use graphical tools, but unfortunately there is not yet a complete GUI for the WireGuard solution. As I said before, it's quite new. But this is no problem. I have put the commands together in a script and you can download them from my GitHub repository. The link is, like always, in the description of the video. The OpenWrt page also links to a page that actually tells you how to gain secure shell access to your router. Under Windows, you may use PuTTY. On the Mac or on Linux, you can just SSH from any shell window. In order to transfer the script, you could either download it from the command line using curl or wget, or you could copy it over using SCP, or the most comfortable way, you could use FileZilla or WinSCP to transfer the file. We just need to install the SFTP software on the router so that it accepts secure FTP connections. Alternatively, you could of course just copy and paste the content of the script into the terminal window. The script only takes seconds to run and it does a lot of things automatically for you. First, it will download and install the necessary software package. Second, it will set up a new firewall rule that allows WireGuard VPN traffic in from the WAN, that means from the internet. Third, it installs a network interface called WG0. This is where we will later set up the so-called peers for WireGuard. I also want to have a graphical user interface in order to see the status and add new connections with a barcode, so I also install the package Lucy App WireGuard. That's all we need to do on the router. Now let's see what we need to do on the iPhone. First, I need to install the WireGuard client. This can be found in the App Store. From the main screen, I can add a new VPN connection using the plus button. I can now either create a new connection from scratch, from a file, or, and that is my preferred solution, from a QR code. So let's go back to OpenWrt, select status, and then WireGuard status. In order to have the barcode displayed, I need the QRN code package, no problem. quickly going back to the package management under System, Software, search for the package at Install It. Here we go. The package is installed and I can scan the QR code. Unfortunately, the current version of this interface does not do everything for me. There are still two or three things I need to do manually. First, let's do this on the iPhone. I need to tell my iPhone where to find the VPN. Here, I can either specify an IP address or a DNS name. Typically, you would put in the name from the dynamic DNS service here, followed by a colon, and then the port number. By default, the port number is 51820. I also need to tell the iPhone which IP address it is going to get on the VPN. That is a bit cumbersome, as I would normally expect this to happen over DHCP, but for a handful of devices like we would expect in a home environment, that's okay. The script has given the WireGuard interface the private IP address 192.168.9.1, so the address of my iPhone needs to be in the same subnet. I have chosen .18, the /32 indicates that this is a single IP address and not a subnet. The other values are okay. In order to allow my iPhone to access the VPN server at home, I need to tell WireGuard about it. WireGuard has no concept of client and service, but rather of so-called peers. So I need to add a new peer. This is done on the network interface, so I need to go to Network, Interfaces, and then click on Edit next to the WGO interface. Here I can review the most important settings of the WireGuard network interface, such as the general settings, the port it is listening on, the private IP address it uses, some additional features such as the maximum transfer units or MTUs, which you should leave unchanged. However, just a little hint here, if you run into issues connecting from a mobile 3G or LTE network, then try lowering this value. With prepaid cards or on public Wi-Fi in the train, I had to lower this to values around 400 to get VPN working stable. But again, leave this unchanged unless you know exactly what you do. The firewall settings show the assigned firewall zone, which is the LAN, and moving over to the peers tab, we can add the iPhone. Here you need to add the public key from your iPhone. Unfortunately, this is not done by the GUI. A way to copy this over from your iPhone would be to create a mail, but rather than sending it, keep it in your drafts and then access it from your PC and copy over the public key. You should not send keys per email in general. Alternatively, you can of course open this page from your iPhone and then copy-paste the value over from Safari. The second field that must be filled out is the allowed IPs field. Here we fill in the IP address, which we specified on the iPhone. Last but not least, we activate routing by clicking the box Route Allowed IPs. That's it. Clicking on Save and Apply restarts the networking services and applies the changes. I can now try and connect from my iPhone to the VPN on the router. It seems to connect, that's fine. Checking the status page on the router, my connection details are shown and the icon goes from gray to blue once I connect. On the iPhone, I may click on Settings and then View Log, which will show me additional information about the connection process. Here we go, I'm connected and may now check my IP cameras at home. Let me launch the IP cam application. Here it is, and yes, I can connect and check the cameras. All good, all working. Guys, that concludes today's episode. In another episode on VPN, we will actually build our own outbound VPN service by renting a server for $1 per month, install VPN software on it, and connect to it from home or from a mobile device. In other words, we build our own VPN service for $1 per month. I'm sure that is an offer you can't refuse. So please make sure that you are subscribed to my channel. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy. Bye for now. The top of the top.